Hi folks, today I bring you a panel that I think belongs to the NLG sound system model XA-S63F or XA-63. It is a panel with 4 buttons, infrared and a very colorful VFD. It used as a driver for the VFD reference MC3501. We have already discussed this driver previously, so there is not so much more to say about it. I would like to remember, however, that any code used in the previous approach will not have the same result in this panel, as it is logical that the driver connections to the VFD at the grid and segment level certainly do not follow the same order, and even if the order is the same, the design and the number of segments will certainly be different per grid. Therefore, it is always necessary to consider the need for some code adaptation when using the same driver but with a different VFD. Let's check out what you need to connect to bring it back to the life, as well as some simple lines of the code used to animation the VFD. The HR325 had to be replaced to reduce the brightness of the LED indicator of the standby or on present in the panel, so that the video is not disturbed. It is a 300 ohms resistor that is in the voltage divider applied to the base of the transistor, K303, as it is a BJT PNP channel, and the fact that it maintains some negative value in the base caused the LEDs to remain in the medium brightness with a value still more negative going to the high brightness. The data present in the printed serigraphy in the PCB requires some care during the connections, as it is listed inversely to the connector's pin identification. The 4 buttons present in the panel working with the parallel mode with the different resistors applied to each button, okay? I will not expend time about the circuit I use, okay, because you already know the pins. Normally it's 3 pins, the clock, data in and strobe, and the G and D reference between the 3 circuits, okay. I make the alert normal. You need 3 independent power sources to the filament. 1 in this case is 3.3 volts, for example, or 4.4, or if you use another power, you can apply diodes in serial mode to reduce the voltage, okay? You have the negative voltage, in this case, we use the converter DC-DC, and the 5 logics, 5 volts logic to the power diver. I implemented a trigger to control the buttons, in this case the 4 buttons, but I only use 1, to control the status of the indicator standby or on of the soundbar. When I press the button, the trigger happen and the LED stay on or off. Note the original configuration to the circuit is to force the LED stay in the middle bright to indicate standby, and intense bright to control to indicate the on status. Okay. The original circuit used to control the LED is based on the polarization of the base of the transistor, through the voltage divider composed of the R325 and the R324. This means that the base is always more negative than the emitter, leaving the transistor in the active zone even when we apply the plus 5 volts to the R324, causing the LED to light up to half brightness. When we apply negative to R324, the transistor goes to the saturation zone, leaving the LED at the maximum brightness. By replacing the R325 with a resistor of the 10K, we prevent the transistor from remaining on the active zone, forcing it to become cut off or saturate in the both situations of the apply 0 volts here at the input of the R324 or plus 5 volts at this point. Because if the base is negative, we have flux between the emitter and the base, which allow the current between the emitter and the collector. If we force the base to one voltage near of the voltage of the emitter, the transistor stay in the cut zone. Okay.